Hello again, everyone. Well, I'm in Daventry while Nikki goes to a conference, so I'm at a bit of a loose end, and I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and have a look at Catesby Viaduct, which is a viaduct on a section of old abandoned railway.
Well, it actually took me quite a while to find somewhere not too antisocial to park, but we're on our way now. It shouldn't be too far down this little track. Yeah, I've only got a few yards, look, and there's some sort of monument and graveyard here. I wonder what that's all about. Yeah, look at this. There's no markings on it really to say what it is, unless it's just an elaborate grave marker. There's nothing really marked on the OS map here. I did wonder if it might be an old churchyard, but there's no church ruins here. There's a sort of a mound thing there. I'm not sure what that is. Yeah, maybe it's just a private graveyard. My horse mate here doesn't seem to know. I've asked him, but he ain't got a clue. Anyway, onwards I suppose. This isn't really what we came for. Well, it's a cracking view from up here, and it's an absolutely gorgeous day. Lovely sunshine. It's a nice farm over there with some sheep, and yeah, we're heading down this way. Lovely well-kept footpath, looks like someone gets down here with a mower or something. Railway sleepers for fence posts, look, we're on the right track. Sorry if the footage is a little bit wobbly today, I haven't got my gimbal with me. Look at that, look, very sort of stereotypical English countryside on a sunny spring day. Well, this is pretty obviously a good spot for badgers. I don't know if that's abandoned badger tunnel, but look at the amount of earth they've thrown up. It's actually buried a good part of the fence on this side. Some solid work there, Mr. Badger. Oh, wow, look at this. Nice tunnel, 1897. Now, I did have an inkling that I'd find this here. I have looked up a little bit online. Looks like it has been open in the past, but some terrible spoil sports have got it all closed up. So, not entirely sure we'll be able to easily get in there. Now, they're pretty determined I'm not going to have a stroll through the tunnel. Look, they've even gone to the lengths of coating the outside in greasy anti-climb paint. I'll poke you in a little ways, though, so you see what you could have won. And that goes quite a long way, if you look at the map. I reckon that must be at least half a mile or so of tunnel in there. Quite large bore as well. So it would make a good little stroll through, but sadly, I don't think we'll get in there today. Besides, of course, chaps, I'm not really equipped today. I haven't really got a light with me of any great power, and don't have a helmet or anything. And obviously, the tunnel's not maintained, so lining might be in poor condition in places. And also, if people have made a determined effort to keep you out, then you obviously shouldn't break in. And really explore places if you can wander straight in, I guess. That's the key. Or you've arranged some sort of official access. Well, there is an open drainage channel here, but yeah, not much airspace in there, really, above the water level, so I don't think I fancy going in that way. Oh, I'm back up on the main footpath here. Pretty nice up here anyway, look. Lovely ponds over there. This grass is kept very neatly mown. That must take someone a while, even on a ride on a lawnmower. Yeah, I guess people up in that house there spend a fair old whack of their time gardening. And we're on a bit more of a farm access road now, so I think we head down here and then bear off to the right a little bit. It should take us back towards the old railway track bed. Oh, look at that, our way on is down through this lovely Avenue of Trees. Sounds like there's some shooting going on in the distance, I can hear. Old sheep all look rather tired. They must have had a bit of a hectic Saturday night, I guess. Out on the town last night, ladies. Still sleeping it off. So I guess this avenue of trees was the original approach to the big house back there. Well, apparently I'm now following the course of the Jurassic Way long distance footpath. It's a pretty neatly manicured path, isn't it? Oh, well, the path here is actually a little bit indistinct. The map shows it going diagonally through that field there. Well, I've come straight through the field because there's just a gate on the other side and this is just a barbed wire fence, so it seemed easier to go through the gate. No obvious sign of a path through the middle, but it is supposed to be the long distance footpath, so I would have thought it'd be quite clear, but yeah, it doesn't really look like anyone comes this way, strangely. Oh, there is a stile here at the end, so it's obviously where you're supposed to come, but yeah, no sign of a path at all across there, so I think many people have walked this way. Oh, well, plenty of lambs about, and look down there, look, there is our first look at the viaduct. Very nice. Also remains of an old bridge down there. Can't believe this weather, it's absolutely gorgeous day again today. Well, there's the remains of the old bridge. It looks like the footpath passes through what would have been the bridge opening. Yeah, somebody's left this rock on the top of a fence post, obviously found it, and I think that, I suspect, is a bit of fossilised seashell. Another bit of engineering here, left over from the railway. I suspect that might have once supported a water tank, maybe. Oh, up on the embankment now, certainly a great view from up here. Well, we're up at the end of the viaduct, and it's actually pretty interesting because the track bed, the sort of clinker track bed, has eroded away. And you can see the construction of the viaduct. You can see how the brick edges are built up. And really, it's only the outer face that's engineering brick. The inside is all red brick. And then it's sort of rubble lined on the inside to build up the surface. I guess you want to make the whole thing out of solid brick. So it's like a casing with a rubble infilling. And you can actually see at the bottom here, it's been lined with asphalt before the rubble has been filled in the middle. I guess that's as a sort of a waterproofing measure and to stop the brickwork getting damaged by frost and such, I would say. You can see by the colour of the rocks there, it's pretty rich in iron. There's a lot of historic ironstone mining not far from here. There we go, this is the top of the viaduct, a little bit overgrown, but you can definitely see where the track bed went. Cracking view from the top. Really is lovely countryside around here. It's interesting that in amongst the clinker for the track bed there's what looks to be sort of irony sort of slag that's definitely been molten and metally at some point. Not very metally, but yeah, that's definitely been molten, hasn't it? That looks like the sort of thing you might get in the waste from ironworks, which I guess makes sense. Around the time that this viaduct was built, there would have been ironworks knocking around, and that's the sort of material that would have been used to make up the track bed. I walked down the embankment to get a better look at it, and look, it's absolutely lovely. What a marvellous piece of engineering. Little tiny bit of graffiti on it, but relatively untouched. not a big fan of graffiti in this sort of setting. Sometimes, I guess, in urban areas it can look quite colourful, but not here really, I don't. Come on, chaps, don't do that. I rather wish I'd got some sort of picnic to eat, but haven't brought anything with me, sadly. There's some definite signs of wear on this side, though. Definitely bad when things like this little tree have got hold. Look, its roots have blown out quite a lot of the brickwork, and then the water has got in and done quite a bit more damage. Looks like the far side, sort of just where the fence line is, maybe it's a different landowner or something, it looks like there's been drains installed sort of at the bottom of the where the arch springs from, I guess, to drain the water out from the track bed just above that asphalt surface. It looks like it's worked, actually. That far side looks, certainly from here, to be in much better condition than this near side, where we don't have the drains. Or at least the drains that are there are much older looking and probably blocked up or something like that. I quite enjoyed that little stroll, but now it's time to go and find some tea and a bun somewhere, I reckon. Well, that's all for now. If you enjoyed it, press like. Subscribe if you want to see some more. Ring the bell to be notified when we upload something new.